Hey guys, Jordan Winkler here. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to quickly go over the best guns that I had experience with in 2015. These aren't necessarily guns that came out in 2015. These are just ones that I hadn't had previous experience with until this last year. You guys know that up until pretty recently, i.e. this last year, I shot a lot of 7.62x39 through a lot of AKs. I love AKs. But I think that I probably shot less than 500 rounds of 7.62 through AKs this last year. It's been the year of the 5.56 for me, or returning to it rather. I've had an AR-15 for a long time, I've shot it a bunch, but I had gotten mostly into AKs in terms of training. So number one on the list of new guns for 2015 will be the SIG MCX in 5.56. It's got a folding stock, it's super lightweight, the irons are great, you can add accessories that you want. I ran it with a Night Force 1x4 NXS scope for a while, and I've shot more rounds through this than any other rifle this last year, and it ran 100%. So it does everything that I wanted to do and more. I would say that pretty close to that would be the SIG 5.56, because it's been just as reliable. It's a little bit heavier. I don't like the stock as much, but I do like the fact that it folds, just like the MCX. Both can fit in a tennis racket bag. It is a little bit more awkward compared to the MCX in terms of getting a cheek weld. And it does come with a cheek riser you can shoot it with, but not my favorite deal. And I should point out that I'm talking about the 5.56 model and the 5.56 calibered 5.56, because I did have an experience with a 7.62 calibered 5.56 model that wasn't that great. Started to throw all those numbers at you, but I didn't name this gun. Okay, number three on the list is the Tavor. And to be honest with you, I was pretty neutral on the Tavor. My wife really wanted one, and she really liked it. And I was like, whatever. I wouldn't really want to be shot with any of these guns, even ones I don't particularly like that much. So a gun is a gun. Is it reliable? Is it accurate? Does it do what I want it to do? That's the most important thing. And the Tavor does all those things in a very short package with all the weight in the back stuff we've talked about in a bunch of videos. Tavor is good to go, guys. There's a couple awkward things that you have to get used to if you've just been running ARs and AKs your entire life, but it's not insurmountable by any means. It's a super fun gun to shoot, and it's handy, and I'd highly recommend the Tavor to just about anybody out there. So that's it for rifles. Now, the best pistol that I had experience and that I acquired this last year and shot was a SIG 226 Tac Ops. Now, I got this in a trade. You guys know that I've had a 226, a regular one, for years, but I wanted the 226 Tac Ops because I shoot the 226 model probably the best of any handgun. Now, I can shoot most handguns just fine. I mean, you line up the sights, put the front sight where you want the bullets to go, and press the trigger without disturbing the sights, you're going to make your hits. Not a big deal, right? But the 226 Tac Ops just makes your life way easier in that regard. It's a wonderful gun. If you're a big guy like me, you can still carry it. It has 20 rounds in the magazine, great sights on it, and overall just a really enjoyable pistol for me to shoot. And I feel great carrying it because I feel like I'm carrying concealed the best gun for me. Next up on the list is the TP9 SA and the TP9 V2. Now, the SA for me edges out the V2 because of the trigger. I really like the trigger on the SA. There's just one trigger press. On the V2, there's multiple trigger presses. I don't think any of them are as good as the SA trigger press. Also, I've had a lot more experience with the SA. It's been super reliable. I put it in the hands of a bunch of students, made a bunch of videos on it. I don't want to say trying to find reasons not to like it, but I kept basically seeing, you know, over the course of testing it, seeing if it would fail, if it would have reliability issues. I mean, it's an inexpensive handgun. But guys, the TP9 SA is good to go. It is accurate with a great trigger, super reliable, pretty lightweight because it has the polymer frame, but you can get, I think the regular magazines have 18 round capacity, and then you can get 20 rounders for it. The V2 is good to go as well. The decocker on the V2 doesn't actually make the trigger go dead. You know, it just makes it a long double action pull, but honestly, the decocker to me is kind of a non-issue. So those are the best rifles and the best pistols that I had experience with in 2015. certainly other wonderful guns out there. I'm looking forward to trying them out. You should go try them out. Find which one that you shoot best, and you should carry that gun. Thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys later.